Hi, I want to thank you for signing up for Atomic Learning and learning about Google Forms and Sheets. This is a little tutorial about the forms. I just want to go over a few things that are a little different compared to the tutorials that Atomic Learning offers. They're still very informational, very accurate, but there's a few things I just want to point out so you're not confused that you're not seeing the exact same thing. For example, I do want to mention something that they did not discuss, and it's very important with inside of Google Apps in Forms. If you're in a form, when you open a new form, you'll notice when you're a Google Apps school, you have the option to require Atlantic Community School District to log in. Also, you have the option to collect the respondent's username, which, for example, if you want to collect my respondent's username, it would be jfinslot@atlanticiaschools.org. You do have that capability within the Google Apps. This is very useful. This is great to collecting in their emails. Also, you can open it to the public by unchecking both of those as well. But I do want to make note of that. If you have more questions, you can please feel free to ask me. The other thing I do want to mention, there's two voices within the tutorials, and one is a gentleman and one is a female. When the gentleman talks and when regarding forms, he does have the little older version of forms. But when he is doing the tutorials, it is regarding the different types of choices for questions. So it all pertains to what you need to know. But when he goes up to the top left-hand side in his screen, he will say add item. In that particular case, you do not have that option anymore to add item. That is the older forms, and we are now on the new forms. So when he goes to add items, you can also go here to question type is what he's referring to, or you could go to insert. So when he talks to add item, I guess I would consider that to be a technology tool to think of the word insert as well. So those are the few things you might want to notice. Also, they notice when he is talking, he does talk about this hovers in yellow. When in the new forms, it does not hover in yellow. It is highlighted in light gray. So just to be aware of those few things. Also, I have taught forms many times to many of you, and there's always something I say every time. And if you get this right, I'll be very excited. But there's three parts to a form. There's the edit part, the live part, and the results part. So do not forget that. There's three parts to a form. And if I was teaching you right now, I'd ask you to repeat those parts to you. There's the edit part, live part, and the results part of a form. And with the new forms, there's two pages. There is the edit and the live. You can access it anywhere, but the responses go to a different sheet. So I do challenge you within this particular section, Unit B and Unit C, Unit 2 and Unit 3, to create a form. Once you create a form, I would like you to try Fliberoo, which is a script that does the grading, which is a multiple choice. So watch that tutorial. Once you have created a form, and I'm hoping you do create a form within watching this tutorial, please share that form with me and I'll be more than happy to fill it out. But forms are great. Forms are great ways of assessment. So feel free to play with the forms portion of this tutorial. Thank you.